Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tim, and it is Thursday evening, so we're here to play some games. Yeah, that sounds like an excellent idea. And today, we're gonna start a brand new adventure because we had the excellent privilege to go ahead and be able to finish a whole bunch of games last weekend. And so it's time for the game that Huntsman's been very much excited for, Tomba. Ah, that's right, ladies and gentlemen, the cult classic PlayStation game Tomba, starring the boy with the pink hair, the titular Tomba, and his magical bracelet that kind of leads him on his merry quest. But first, a little bit of backstory here. We see that Tomba is a very complex character who is driven by the hunger that is inside of him, the hunger for pig flesh. Simply that, pig flesh, really. Like, come on, who doesn't enjoy a nice little hunk of ham every now and again, you know what I mean? And so, one day upon eating his meal, he encounters these evil pigs. And these evil pigs seem to be doing evil things with their evil snouts. Tomba can't let that go by because, well, again, that insatiable hunger takes over and he says, pigs and I must eat! And unfortunately, George of the Jungle's right past them and into the tree. But it's okay. They can only scramble so far when you have a mace head on a rope. Like, that's probably one of my favorite weapons that I've seen in a video game in a while. It's literally just like the head of a mace on the end of a rope that he whips around. It's pretty awesome. And so, unfortunately, the evil pigs do defeat us and make their way out with our magical bracelet. Those bastards. And off we go, beginning our quest. In a freeze frame. Perfect timing, really, if you ask me. And with no further bother, let us start the game. So you know what? This is one of those that I have played a decent number of times, but usually I barely get past the first half of the game because it's a little involved. Like, it takes some time to actually get through this fucking thing because it's a platforming RPG. Like, it's a very Japanese game, as you'll see by the fact that, well, you'll see. It's weird. It's Japanese, and it's great. But it is a little bit, well, not longish. I mean, we've been playing Final Fantasy X, for fuck's sake, so our gauge of long games is a little bit skewed at the moment. So I'd say it's shorter than Final Fantasy, but longer than Devil May Cry. But anyway, hey, me with the pink hair. Yeah, that's right, me with the pink hair. I've never seen you around here before. That's because we're new here. We just got our bracelet stolen. Well, if you need info, go to the small hut at the top of that hill up again. This crazy old geezer lives up there, but he should be able to help you out. Before you go, check out all the signs along the way. The local visitors bureau did a great job of supplying the helpful info to the visitors. Read the signs, go up and do the tutorial mode. By the way, what's with that pink hair anyway? Never mind, I don't want to know. See ya. It turns out that pigs are kind of like carrots. Once you eat enough of them, your hair just turns that same shocking pink that most pig flesh is. And so here we are, playing as Tomba. You can see we do actually have that mace head on a rope, which we can use to bash and smash enemies. Tomba can run, Tomba can jump, and Tomba has a menu at which he can use various items along the way. Those will all come in handy as we go forward. But anyway, so we have our trusty blackjack equipment, and the blackjack is in fact that weapon that lets us hit things and hurt things. Stop it, come back. And basically along the way, we will encounter various quests. Yeah, we have normal pants on for now. Don't worry, Queen. That will change. You saw the little monkey that climbed up the tree just a minute ago. Whatever happened to little Monk? We can swing while we hang from a tree branch. Press and hold the left and right directional button to swing. And if you want to swing in the opposite direction, just hold that opposite direction. And we can also press the X button to jump off the branch. Woo! But it actually does nothing for us right now. Because, as you can see, there are actually some planes to operate on here. There's a foreground and a background. Oh, God. Well, I mean, I'm sure, technologically speaking, it is a lot better. But I like this one. It's good. Branch swings. Well, that's basically just the instructions we just got. Ooh, hello, Mr. Froggy. we acquired a quest. Take me home. We are going to hold that froggy on our back for a while until we find where his home is. Wherever could the little piggy's home be? Oh. It's a farting flower. I love it. And so on we move. Hello. It's Big Hat Gentleman again. Oh, heading off to the old man's hut already, huh? Unfortunately, the fog is so thick up ahead, you can't see a damn thing. Looks like we'll have to turn around. Did you dye your hair or is it naturally that pink? Never mind, I don't want to know. If only I had my nature survivalist mail order catalog. I'm sure there would be something I could order out of there to get rid of this fog. Oh well, bye-bye. So there's a fog problem up ahead, huh? And the frog ran away. Damn it. Oh well. We'll find out where the frog goes in a minute. But first... We see the world ahead of us. And it looks beautiful. I don't see any fog at all. What the hell is that guy talking about? We'll find out. I assure you, the fog is there, and it is thick enough to cut with a knife. And we'll go ahead and destroy some grapes on the side for some reason. And there's that damn fog, which we must clear. We'll get 500 experience to clear away the fog, and we need an item with which to do so. Where, because we have already, have we seen an item that might be windy of some kind? Ooh! We acquired some chicks. You know what? Like that frog, there's nothing that you can acquire in this game that doesn't have some sort of purpose at some point in the future. So where will those chicks come in handy? That is the question of the hour. And also, what's in the chest? We can't find out, because it's locked. Also, the sounds he makes are really, really, really cute and really awesome. Exercise routine number 3, weapon workout. Hold down the circle button to swing your weapon. If you swing your weapon really fast, the attack will become more powerful. As you saw, when we held down the circle button to, hit the enemy for longer, it actually reached further. So regular distance, regular distance, regular distance, and swing much further. Now. You make funny joke, Huntsman. You make funny joke at my expense, and I do not appreciate. Well, hello there, windy mailbox. And that went ahead and blew me back forward. Great, I wasn't quite ready to travel back here yet. But, if you remember those little planes of exploration that I was talking about earlier, you'll realize, we can actually still do the thing. But, I still can't reach that damn monkey. No matter what way I try. But we can actually go back over to the house and make our way back into the foreground. Now that foreground and background interaction will absolutely come back later on in the game. But there's something that I want to do first besides grab the frog. I wanted the frog. Give me the damn frog. Yay, frog acquired. What I wanted to do is trigger this pig. Come here, pig. Yes, you. Yes. Yes, you, pig. Ow, the frog ran away. Damn it. Come here, pig. Yeah, got it. The peach fart transformed it into a tiny pig. It's a little teeny tiny pig. I want it. It's a little teacup pig. Baby pig. We got the peach flower gas quest. So I guess along the way we'll figure out exactly what's going on with these peach flowers and why they suddenly turn big pigs. Not so big. But unfortunately, that frog ran away, so we still don't know where his home is right now. But that's okay. We know that we can use items. We have this furious tornado item. Let's use it. And furious tornado whoosh! As a cutscene plays, and the wind blows the fog straight away. Good wind. Good wind. But that's why it's in this game. I never had it. It was here the whole time. I just have to find a way to open that chest and I'll get my skill back. God, if that's where it's been this whole time. But anyway, I want to get the fruit that is right here. Because as it turns out, the fruit heals you. And there is a way. Excellent. to make our way over here without needing the run dash that you get from the other side. Save data here? You bet your sweet ass we will. And we have our first save point. New block. Is this block okay?
Yeah,
just fine. So on our merry way, we continue. You know what? The thing that I love most about this game, really, at the end of the day, is how it's just so bright and colorful, you know? And frilly and fun and unique. There really hasn't been a game like this in this generation. I mean, seriously, come on. And it's one of those things where I understand why, you know, these side-scrolling platformers are antiquated. They're rough around the edges now. And I got 2 1-ups from that.
Yay!
We took one frog home, but I'm curious whether we can go back and get that second frog at some point and bring him all the way back here. And whether that would actually, like, finish out the quest for us or something like that. Come here. Come here, stupid bird. And also even stupider pig. I must fart on you a second time. Okay, that's you know, a little bit more fun than it should be. Let's see here. There's a run somewhere in this game. I know there is. I just don't remember the button with which to do it. Anyway, oh right, the frog was over here in this little area of polyps. Come here, you stupid frog. Aww. Do I have to exit the screen and then come back in order for him to like respawn or something? Probably. And frog time. Oh, don't you worry. If anything, these streams are proving exactly your point. Oh no, never mind. I guess we could only do one frog, or we only needed to do one frog, or it was that same frog, but he just migrated a little bit. I don't know. Either way, it doesn't matter. Ow! Got caught by the piranha plant, and of course, the first thing it does is plop me back down in the rest of them. Fuck off, you stupid piranha plants. I hate them so much. And suddenly, I am down to one fucking health. Great. I need to find some berries super duper quick. Excellent. Okay, and ask and ye shall receive. No, Dan, you really haven't missed a whole lot yet. We're just kind of getting into Tomba. And of course, yes, I am bad at bat. If you want to talk to somebody, press the square button. If only there was somebody for us to talk to. I imagine we'll find somebody soon. Oh, come here. Yay, more chicks. Oh. We almost lost some of the precious, precious health we just got. And I think that that back way is actually the way down, and this front way is the way up. We'll go ahead and climb this little bit of netting. Oh, look at that. We got a little bit of displacement there on the netting as we climb up it. That's neat. That's a good effect. And we continue to scale our way up the mountain, with the background becoming ever clearer. Look at that shit. That is so nice. You can, it definitely gives you a sense of scale. You know, you can tell now that we are going just super duper high. Hey, Harwood, welcome. Glad you could join us. Come here, you stupid fucking bird. Yay! We unlocked the AP box. Oh wait, no, we unlocked the quest for the AP box. We actually need to get 50,000 experience or AP in order to be able to get that little bonus box there. And I still need something else in order to be able to unlock those. Oh, but look, we found the 100-year-old man's hut. Surely he will have some good information for us. Or maybe just a toffee. I wouldn't mind a toffee candy right about now. I don't know, Huntsman. I honestly don't know. I haven't played Tomba 2. I would have to kind of play it a little bit off stream to see what it's like. You know, and whether or not it would be worth it to go straight into it or take a little bit of break in between, because there's about to be a whole slew of stuff coming out here shortly. Anyway.
Why, hello there. You're a cute little fella. Yes, I am the 100-year-old wise man. What can I do for you?
Yes, unfortunately, this is another one of those games where I get to do a whole fuckload of voices again, so saddle in. You're in for a bumpy ride. Oh, sorry. Yes, I farted a little bit. My mind is preoccupied with something else at the moment. Say, would you do me a favor? You see, there's something that just really is bothering me. It's this. You see, we have these red coca birds here. Those darn birds steal eggs and raise them as your own. Oh! You mean those birds and chicks that we've been collecting along the way? Could you go out and collect all the chicks? Good job, we found them all. I was like, we found like four so far, so that's gotta be at least half of them, if not all of them. And it turns out, oh God. It turns out he was keeping them in his mouth and puked up all four birds right there. You kept them in your stomach? Oh God, what else do you keep in that? Never mind, you don't need to show me. It's all right, really. I think they're just gonna keep making fun of Tomba this entire time and then saying never mind before they can get the answer.
Thanks to you, I have one less thing to worry about right now. Yes, you wanted to see me about something. So the coma pig stole your grandfather's bracelet. You should have been a better grandson and kept a better hold of that damn thing. You know how those pigs love shiny things. Here's how the story goes.
This was once a beautiful, peaceful land.
No, I actually wasn't too far off from his real voice.
They suddenly appeared and you changed this land.
Now we get some plot. The world has changed with those motley little grape egg pus ball things, because that's a part of the mutation of the evil pig spell.
Evil pigs are hiding somewhere in this world. If you find them, I'm sure you'll be able to find your bracelet as well. Just remember, be very careful.
Okay, old man. I shall be incredibly careful as we track down our seven evil ex-pig boyfriends and kill them all. Love it.
Now that's all I have to say about those coma pigs. If you wish to retrieve your bracelet, you should make some friends. They'll be a great help to you. Of course, if there's anything I can do for you, just come back here. I seem to have lost my 100-year-old bell. I was going to give it to you. If you find it, would you return it to me in place of the bell? I give you this, an ancient key. This key also is 100 years old. Ah, time goes by so fast. This is the only key that will open the 100-year-old chests.
I wonder if those are the chests that look like the one that he just opened. Yes, is the answer to that question.
Go ask the dwarf elder about the evil pig bags.
The evil pig bags being the only way to defeat the evil pigs. Turns out, all you gotta do is put an evil pig inside of its bag and then, like, throw it in the river. Yeah, not a whole lot can survive that.
Now run along, youngster.
Sweet. And so we have our first forward-facing quest. The dwarf elder. Somewhere along that big old shiny rope here will be a dwarf elder for us to find out more information from. But we just got ourselves some fancy new loots. So let's go ahead and take a look around here and see what we can now get thanks to our new shiny 100-year-old key, shall we? Oh, look, another bird to kill. I do love the jumping mechanics in this game, goddammit. And of course we fucked it up. But that's okay, because all we have to do. Oh God fucking Jesus shit cunting, damn it Christ. Are you kidding me? Already with the death. Yes, of course. But it's okay. Because all we gotta do is go down here. And I wanna see what's over here at this pond. Wait. Is that a dude in that window? It is. What, you found me already? I was trying to hide from you. Well, since you found me, I'll give you a little hint. To the right of me behind this hut, there's a little pond. Well, yeah, we kind of put the frog there. If you go up the hill above here, you can meet this crazy old colt. He's supposed to be a wise 100-year-old man, but he just seems to mumble a lot to me. I agree. Who the hell are you, shadowy figure? I must know.
Who am I? Never mind that. Just go see the places I told you about. We'll talk again later. You've already been there. People call me Yan of the Hidden Village.
Oh, I see. Because we kind of found him out of order, I guess it skips a step. And now we have to play hide and go seek with Yan.
I like to hide from people. Usually they never find me. If you find me again, I'll give you more information. Don't expect it to be so easy next time. This is gonna be a lot of fun. A good old game of hide and go seek. Good luck.
No, he had kind of neon yellow hair and looked more like a caveman?
I guess. Weird.
Okay, we'll find him again. We will find him again. Mainly because his quest line said hide and go seek, but because, you know, we have to. And let's travel across the pond. On the back of a delightful turtle.
You wanna get past me, huh? Can you swim? You stupid fucker. Just because you got pink hair, you think you cool or something, you can't even swim. That's what I thought. Mr. Turtle save you this time, and next time, you won't be so lucky. You can't go past the door here unless you can swim. Trust me, you're not up to it yet. Come back after you learn how to swim. Hey, you hungry? Why don't you take this with you?
So, he's a huge dick and like kicks us back in the water, but then gives us bananas to eat? Whatever, dude.
See you later. Much later. Smell you later, jackass.
God, what a jerk. But at least he gave us some bananas, so when we do go swimming, we won't get a cramp. But now, I think there was another chest somewhere over here. But it was a slightly different design. I'm assuming that we can't open it up yet, but it never hurts to check. Damn, still locked. It's worth a shot to check. Anywho. De-be-boo-ki-ha. I hate those fucking things so much. I just like keep beating them with my hammer. To express my rage and anger against them. But now, we actually have two things that will help us here. We have this 100-year-old key, which will help us open this chest. And find the 100-year-old bell, something that is incredibly useful. You'll see what it does here in a minute. But the second thing that we got was that bunch of bananas, which, as it turns out, is exactly what you need to lure a pesky monkey down from his little tree hidey hole. We just have to find out. There's a goddamn platform somewhere along in here. And I can't remember where it is. And it's hard to find, which is kind of bullshit. And you can, like, hear me hitting it every so often. Tim, look at the backside. Yeah, I mean, that's what I thought. Like, you were saying look at the backside. I was like, I'm pretty sure that it's up front because the monkey's up front. I just can't get the fucking placement right. God damn it. Like, you can hear me landing on a thing. Why won't it let me fucking do it? It's another little sliding, or a swing pole. So I guess I'm just not hitting it right. There we go, nailed it. He says, after the fifth try. And you have to time it just right to be on the top. Damn it. Okay, now that I know where it's at, I can hit it every time. But what you have to do is actually swing upwards, which is a little bit trickier. Wait, oh, going around and around and around and up. There we go, nailed it. Hi. I'm sorry, little monkey friend. I didn't mean to bite you on the nape of the neck. Get off of me. Leave me alone. I haven't eaten all day. And young pink hair is giving me a headache. We found ourselves a hungry little monkey. And what do you give a hungry little monkey that's angrier than he should be? Why, a bunch of bananas.
Wow, you're giving me all of your bananas?
Thanks, you're not so bad after all. I was so hungry I couldn't move.
My name is Charles.
Charles the monkey.
Charles the chimp.
I know what I'll do for you. I'll teach you a trick, okay? Press the square button and the directional button together to run.
It's called the animal dash. Awesome. Finally, we have the ability to speedily get through some of these larger squares, like so. See the animal dash. The animal dash that leaves a delightful trail of glitter behind us. We're so fabulous. When you run this fast, you ain't got time to be nothing but fabulous. And it also lets us climb a lot faster too. Like you've seen me kind of grab onto some of these ledges and such. It lets you do weird shit like the Mega Man X dash jump to where you can hold down the button and woo, woo, and jump up a lot faster. I'll be able to show you on an area where there's a wider area of jumps, but the point is, you can move a lot faster and a lot easier now that you have this animal dash. Like so, see? I still don't think I can get up there yet, but we can go this way. Or we can travel a much more convenient way because we have in our possession this 100-year-old bell, which comes down, plays a little tune, and we warp immediately back to the 100-year-old man's place.
I gave you a bell that made you come back to me, Tomba. I hope you don't think that's weird.
Oh, you're injured. Let me take a look at you. No bad touch. Bad touch. Did he heal us? I think he might have healed us and also just used the bell twice, but that's beside the point. I think he just healed us. Without it giving me like any sort of prompt or confirmation on that. But yeah, no, creepy old man is creepy. Oh, wait a minute. There was something that I think I overlooked. Because if I remember right... Yeah, there's one more little thing that we need to get before we can move on. And it's another appearance from one of our friends that we're going to acquire along the way. The 100-year-old man said it would be wise for us to acquire new friends and allies. So let's go ahead and start early. And not have to wait. Wait a minute. Where you at? Oh, goddammit. If I remember right, I wonder if because we reached the old man, see, I've never gotten that out of order where I've completely forgotten about Yan before I got the old man. So you actually learn that he's Yan right there on that spiky platform that I was on just a minute ago, the platform with the little spiky leaves. And then he tells you to come here to the 100-year-old man. But because I found him after I had already talked to the 100-year-old man, I wonder if it kind of sped along the process a little bit. It did kind of skip a step for us right there in the dialogue, so I wonder. It's a very springy rope to be stretched so taut from the old man's chimney to the dwarf village. Not really sure how I feel about that. I do wish it gave like a boingy boing. That would be fun. Oh, you must be a dwarf who speaks in Gurgs and Grubs? Oh, it's a unique language. And we must learn said language. But how? I mean, the only way that I really have to... Oh. Turns out we can collect a lot more than just frogs and chicks. We now have leaf butterflies to acquire. That's fun. How else do we acquire anything in this game? We jump on it and bite it in the fucking face. And so by jumping on a bunch of those dwarves, we will in fact unlock the dwarf language and be able to interact with them and start some of the dwarf quests, which are the next area. And hopefully, come here, you stupid butterfly. I want it. You
will be mine. I will acquire you. There you are. I don't know what they're gonna be for, but I want as many as I can before we actually move on to the next area. So we're just gonna be basically sitting here farming leaf butterflies at some point in the future. But anyway, enough butterfly catching for today. I think we've had our fun. Come here. And that's dwarf language level 2.
Yay!
Curiosity begs the question, what talking to them looks like now? Now that we're at level 2. All the way up to the top. This house looks like somewhere that we'll be able to go, but we can't go yet. So up and over we go. And these are big old spiny plants. I don't like big old spiny plants. Ow! They look like giant spiked dicks. And wow, if there is one thing that a dick should never be, it is spiked. Giant is okay. Spiked, not so much. Unless you're a cat. Yeah. And we acquire dwarf language level 3. Do 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 do. It seems as though we're blocked in the dwarf village. Now, hello boys. Anything to say? Thragara nerg is gur. Hi. So we're getting closer to being able to understand them. Wow, you learned some of our language. You speak common? But I still ain't quite understanding everything you're saying. I think if you jump on a dwarf and bite one more, you'll have mastered our language. So apparently, I guess that's the tradition in this world, in this place, is you, yeah, would acquire the dwarf language by jumping on people and biting them. So there we are. We now know Dwarfian. God, this game is so weird and fun, and I love it. Hello, boys. My name is Tomba.
We have a problem and don't know what to do.
You know, Dan, I actually really liked Guacamelee. I enjoyed the shit out of that.
The dwarf forest was cast under a spell by the evil pigs. The flowers have wilted away and the trees have mutated. Several dwarves have not returned from a recent hunting party.
These are like dwarven robots, I guess.
We suspect they might have been trapped by the giant's force and can't move. The doors to the huts in the forest have been opened, but the deep forest is being guarded. The guards won't let anyone pass until the missing dwarves have been found.
Okay, so there are some missing dwarves inside of that forest, and we're gonna have to bust them out of whatever spores or pods or giant hanging testicles that they may be under, in, on. Not a single dwarf has returned yet. No shit, because I haven't gone out to find them yet. Can a man do his goddamn job around here? Can a man do his goddamn job? I didn't fucking think so. We have a village. Let's see if we can talk to people. We have a language. Have you seen a child? A child? A small child? He went to go look for flower seeds at the watchtower and hasn't come back yet. I'm really getting worried. What if something happened? Okay, so I guess we'll find a watchtower and a lost child somewhere along the way. Hi. What am I gonna do without the grumble? Oh, hello. I guess I didn't notice you walk up. If you'll excuse me, I'm trying to deal with a problem here. I had something very special in the forest, but I'm afraid to go get it because of all those evil pigs. Oh, evil pigs. They're always rooting around, getting their snouts into things that they don't belong in. It's very important to me. I don't know what I'll do without it. Okay. I guess we'll find whatever keepsake. Help, some dwarves are missing. We open the dwarves. Yep, we know about that. My friend was caught by one of the spores in a tree and is just hanging there. Okay. The kid who lives in this hut has not returned home yet. Well, I guess we have our task at hand. There's a lost child. That lady lost something very precious to her somewhere in the forest. And then there are all the dwarven workers that are somehow trapped in some of these pig spores that are around.
And suddenly, the giant spire cactus dicks have hoods on them. Look, I'm not gonna ask any questions. It makes them slightly less dangerous, so whatever. But, question. Aha, question answered. Will there in fact be dwarves under these things? Yes, there will be. And there will also be lots and lots of berries, which is great, because I want them berries. I want them goddamn berries, son. I only found two dwarves already. Sweet. Ooh, looky looky. We actually were high enough to be able to acquire our first second weapon. Our first weapon upgrade in a wood boomerang? Okay, let's get on some stable ground and figure out what the fuck that does. Huh, I missed one mushroom cap there. Can't let that happen.
Whee!
And down to the ground floor we go. Sweet!
Yep.
Okay, so if this hut here is now open, I wonder if that will lead us to this watchtower that we've heard so much about. But the wood boomerang sounds pretty interesting. What does that do? Is it just a straight upgrade? It doesn't seem like it does anything different. It goes a little bit further. That's nice. Does it do more damage? Also, those are 100% giant hanging testicles. Like, I made that joke because that's kind of how I remembered them. But upon further review, those are giant hanging testicles, and we have to rebound them on the ceiling in order to possibly make them pop. To free the little people who are inside. Excuse me, not little people. The dwarves who are inside. I'm sorry. I misspoke. There we go. That's the one I wanted. Nope, that is not the one that I wanted, because it didn't in fact burst. God damn it. Maybe you? Come here. Damn it. I missed. I missed the little polyp. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. Oh. It's a blue chest. I assume we're going to need another kind of key for that. I don't know what key, though. Curiouser. Here's the thing. If there's a 100-year-old man, how old does a man really get in this world? That 100-year-old man was certainly rather spry to be flirting with us the way he was, so clearly 100 is the new 30 around here. Sweet. So now that's four of them, and we have, fuck off, two left, and we got some charity wings. I didn't think I was doing so bad that I needed some charity, but I guess this game had other ideas. Anyway, whatever, give me your damn butterfly. If you're gonna insult me, the least you can do is give me some, loot for it, asshole. So, where there's fire in a forest, that's a bad thing, right? Like, I'm 99% sure that that is a bad thing for there to be that big of a flame inside of this very dry florid forest. Like, all of these autumn leaves on the ground are incredibly dry and basically just waiting for a flame. Ooh, puppy! Who the fuck lost a puppy out here? Here, boy. Wait, you weren't here a minute ago. Hi. I heard a puppy barking near the spores. I don't think that he can get down. Puppy? Did the puppy get stuck in the spores too? Oh, puppy. Come here, I'll get you down, boy. Wait. Huh. Oh, damn it. I'll bet you he's not stuck in a spore. He's not stuck in somebody's face. He's actually stuck, come here. God damn it. There we go. It's like, you stupid spore, just let me ride you to the top. There we go. Oh, god damn it. I hear it. I hear you, little puppy.
just don't see.
Unless it's over here. Yay! It actually made it up here to where the chest was. Not over to the far side, where I was trying to jump to. Hee-haw! And now we can actually haul some ass out of here. Because between these covers for the giant spiny dicks and my animal run, we can move quickly. Sweet, so only two left, right? Oh, three dwarves have not returned. Three, that's a lot more dwarves than I thought there would be still out there in the world. Wait, where's the puppy? Please tell me the puppy didn't just go back. Okay, good, I was about to say. Who lost the puppy? The kid who lives in this hut has not returned home. Hi, I had something very special in the forest, oh yeah. You, madam. But what have we here? Oh, this little guy looks hurt. Did the puppy get hurt getting climbing all the way down to the top of the tree? Did those evil pigs hurt that puppy? Oh, they're so evil, those pigs. Why don't you leave the pup here with me for a while? Don't worry, I'll take good care of him. What's his name? He doesn't have a name. Baron! Oh, what a great name. Baron! We got ourselves a new best friend. Our little puppy named Baron, he's so cute. Healing herbs will heal any kind of wound. But they only grow on Phoenix Mountain. Yeah. I imagine it's like in Young Frankenstein when you say Frau Brula and like lightning crashes and the horse is whinny. They're like, what the fuck was that? It's too dangerous to go there now. The winds are far too strong. But we need healing herbs for Baron, so I imagine it's not really gonna matter. We're gonna have to take on that area whether it is windy or not. But in the meantime, we still have three dwarven workers to find. Wherever the fuck they are. So let's go see. Yeah. Yeah. Ah, ow, fucker. Oh, you know what? I actually don't think I need to come back to this. Wait a minute. Do you see what I see? We have 50,000 fucking AP, and that means we can get that box and see what loot is inside. Ah, I do love completing quests. I don't remember, actually, what is inside of that goddamn thing. But I know that completing quests is a good thing, so we might as well come back over here while I'm thinking about it. And pick up the AP box. Which heals me a lot. And gives me more AP. Cool. As it turns out, Queen, we didn't need the pesky old man to be able to heal us. We can heal ourselves just fine, so long as we can keep completing quests. Goodbye, old man. You're not going to touch me creepily this time. But let's see here. So now I guess I kind of have to run all the way back over to the other side of the goddamn pig forest, huh? Ugh. What a long trek. I mean, you know, the animal dash makes it better, but... Oh, God. There's still that risk of getting your ass handed to you while you're trying to move quickly. Yes, I made it look pretty by landing back on the pig after he punched me in the face, but more often than not, it does not end so smoothly for you or Tomba. Whee! 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 As far as the mushroom forest goes, it actually is a little bit better through that little hanging testicle portion to kind of take your time and maybe take the high road there. But this is actually where we wanted to go. Inside of this little hidden tunnel that was blocked before. But now it opens up to the watchtower. Where yes, we will in fact save our goddamn data. Because I've come a little bit further along than we have, oh, I don't know, 27 minutes ago? Anyway. I wonder if we can get on top of that. Ow! What a spiny legged bag of asses. Ugh. Oh, and That actually gives us a new XP bar, a green one. And as it turns out, that does give us a new quest. And there was a place on top of that. I was like, I'm just gonna run up there and check and see if there's something on top of there, and it turns out there was. That's gonna hurt. Aww. And we have acquired our second pair of pants. The jumping pants. Those actually make me jump substantially higher. Not gonna lie to you. Neat. Okay, so it seems if we, and we don't actually get any experience that way either. Wow. It seems if we were to hit them with our boomerang, they flip upside down and you can no longer jump on them. But you can hit them again with your boomerang and kill them. You dig? Fuck. Yeah, I don't know how we're gonna be able to get on that one without doing some tricks. Oh, this way. Duh. Neat. I think they very much match my pink hair. Pink hair, purple pants. It's all the rage these days. But I mean, to be completely honest with you, the one thing that I am the most curious about is what, pray tell, effect does that little EXP bar that pops up have with the enemies? Also, is that just like an entire forest floor filled with these dead spider legs? Because that's super duper creepy, actually. That's like ridiculously creepy. I get that there's supposed to be spines in most video games, but normally they're not made of the legs and bodies of the enemies. That's super creepy. And I think it's probably one of my favorite things about this game so far. Come here. Gotcha. There we go. And we got one of the dwarven workers that was hanging up here in a little spore pack. I believe you saw that just a minute ago. Whee! Damn it. Yeah, here's the bad part, Queen. That's gonna happen more often than I would like because this game's fucking hard. And I do not, by any stretch of the imagination, proclaim to be good at it. Okay? Not even close. But we don't always play the games that I'm good at. We just play the games that are fun. And this game is super duper fun. If not slightly frustrating. But that's basically 90s platforms in a nutshell. Oh, god damn it. Oh, I was about to get super mad if I had just skimmed over all of that. And it turns out we got two of the last three dwarves. The third dwarf is around here somewhere, but the question is, where? And also, it appears we have ourselves a little L-shaped petal flower platform. Okay, we can go ahead and pull it down into place, and I assume that means that we can just jump our way to victory. But what lies at the top of a very tall structure like this? Why, a watchtower. What? I wonder what we shall find here. Well, to start off with, we can get on top of the bloody thing. And we found a telescope. Huh. And a new quest called Look and See. You actually notice that there's a tiny little pole here that has the smallest little curve in it. I don't know if you can really see that on the stream, but right here, we're next to Tomba's pink hair, is the slight little curve. And that's your hint that you're supposed to use a telescope here for another cutscene. Aw, beautiful waters. Surely nothing horrible can lie out there. Oh my god! Spider Pig Skull Island! And it net us 1,000 more AP. Neat. Huh. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is Evil Pig Island. And that is something we'll be coming back to a whole lot later on. But speaking of coming back to things, we're gonna take a short break. And when we come back, we have more Tomba on the schedule. That's right, our pink-haired, purple-panted hero has a lot further to go in his quest, and we're gonna try like hell to lead him through it. Don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back. You're watching us on twitch.tv/. My name is 11. Bye.